When you own a wheelchair, you need to know how to look after it. Wheelchairs are amazing inventions and I love my chair. So I want to make sure that I look after it. My chair is how I get around in the world. They handle all different terrains and weather conditions, so they need to be maintained to remain in the best condition so they can make it easier to get around. I have a manual wheelchair, so I'm going to show you what I do to look after my wheelchair. Now, looking after my chair, I have things that I do weekly and monthly. Sometimes I'll need help from a friend or a carer, but mostly I've helped to help is my wheelchair maintenance toolkit, which includes set of Allen keys, pump air compressor, set of tire levers, cloth toothbrush and cleaning spray, spare inner tube, emergency CO2 cartridge from bicycle shop, tire repair. So I'll start with the things that I do every week. The first being keeping my chair clean. I wouldn't want to go out in dirty clothes, so I don't want a dirty chair. Keeping it clean also helps prevent dirt buildups and keeps it working efficiently. I wipe down my wheelchair frame weekly, avoiding using cleaners with bleach. Also, I have longer hair, so often my hair will get caught in the caster wheels, so it's a good idea to pull hair out weekly. My hair actually also gets caught sometimes between the wheels, so I take the wheels off and remove any strands of hair. And I use a toothbrush to remove dirt from difficult to get areas, such as the front casters. The next thing I do weekly is checking tire pressure. To check, you do the pinch test, which involves pinching the sides of your tires. If you can easily pinch in the walls, you may need to pump them up. It's easiest to do this with an electric air compressor, which I have, but you can do with a pump as well. Just takes a bit more work. When pumping my tires, I inflate them to around 105 to 110 PSI, but your wheelchair might be different. You should check with your wheelchair supplier or healthcare professional to find out what you should pump yours up to. The last weekly task is to check my brakes, which can be as simple as taking note when I transfer out of my chair if my wheels are holding or not. If they're not, the first thing I do is check if my tires are correctly inflated. And if they're fine, I check nuts and bolts to see if there's any excessive play or movement. If this doesn't work, I loosen the two bolts on the wheel lock clamp, and this will allow me to move the wheel lock into the correct position, then retighten the two bolts. Remember, if you over-tighten the wheel lock, it will make it very difficult for you to apply brakes. Now, this is what I do for my wheelchair. Yours will be different, so check with your healthcare professional or wheelchair supplier how to keep the brakes in good order. Now for the monthly to-do list. For me, I try and do these things in the first week of the month. And the first thing is checking the chair to see if there's any loose nuts or bolts. What I do is run fingers over nuts and bolts on the frame, brakes, and hand rims to see if any come loose. If they are loose, use the correct size Allen keys to tighten. Just be careful not to over tighten, thread the bolts. Next, I check the casters and if they need to be replaced, which isn't very often at all, but good to check. And how you check is you spin the wheel and if it wobbles or if it doesn't spin freely, then it needs to be replaced. You can see mine are fine, so don't need to be replaced. So I wash the seat cover at least once a week, but if you have a gel cushion like me, then you need to check the gel cushion once a month for any low spots and the foam base for any signs of compression. We want to make sure the gel in the cushion is doing its job properly and protecting our skin. We don't want any pressure sores. I then can just clean the cushion with a warm soapy cloth avoid submerging in water, just a cloth. Then make sure everything is completely dry before reassembling. There you go. There are a few things that I do to help look after my wheelchair and keep it in good condition. But remember, my wheelchair is different from yours. So it's a good idea to ask your healthcare professional or wheelchair supplier how to best look after your wheelchair. I want my chair in good condition so I can do all those fun wheelchair skills. If you're interested in those videos, check out this playlist here. Remember to subscribe and click that thumbs up if you found this video helpful.